Welcome to New Beginning Outreach International. We invite you to our services at 12 noon or live at 1205 at slogaroo.com. We also have Breaking Bread Bible Study every other Tuesday at 6:30 p.m. Let's get ready to enjoy the service. Remember to spread love under God's grace everywhere respectfully to rejoice on and on. See you soon.
God is good. Let's give him one more praise, y'all. Seed can be a seed of faith. That seed can be a seed of helping people. It can be a seed of anything that you have in the ground, because you're expecting a return. Glory to God. And also to be a money seed. Glory to God. Whatever you have in the ground, you have to be expecting. Glory to God. Something to come from that. My God, my God. Hallelujah. We want to welcome everybody to New Beginnings Outreach International. Those who tuned in on the Slug TV Network. Amen. We just want to celebrate our Lord and Savior today. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Glory to God. He didn't have to wake us up, but he did. And it's a blessing to be in the house of the Lord. Like Mama say, one more day. One more day. God is good, right? He's good all the time. All the time. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Amen. I'm excited about being in the house of the Lord. I say this every Sunday, and that means I ain't lying. Amen. Amen. I ain't lying. I love to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. Because I come looking for change. I come looking for something. I come looking just to touch the hem of his garment. Glory to God. Just being in the glory to God. Being in the presence of God is truly a blessing. Amen. It's truly a blessing. Truly a blessing. We're going to flow right on what we've been doing. Amen. We're still in a strong, courageous series. Amen. Last week, we talked about sanctify yourselves. Amen. And we're just flowing through Joshua until we get up into our next phase of what we have to do. Amen. Amen. We just left Joshua 3. And then I'm going to paraphrase on what Joshua 4 was talking about. Amen. And Joshua 4 was just talking about being sanctified as they was being set apart. Amen. And they went. And they grabbed each man from each tribe of Israel and told him to grab a stone. Uh-huh. And they told him to grab a stone. And when they grabbed that stone, they supposed to put the stone all in the pile. When they're going to put them in the pile, it's going to be 12 stones in the pile. So whenever everybody would walk by and see those stones, they would know what that pile meant. Glory to God. They picked up those stones as they walked through the Jordan. Uh-huh. When Joshua had been obedient to God, he said, I'm going to let the people know that they will honor you how they did Moses. I'm going to allow you to walk through the Jordan on dry land. So as they walking through, they told every man to grab a stone.
Come on.
Glory to God. And place that stone right there so people could see that stone came out of the river Jordan.
Yes.
And we crossed by. So every time people walk by those stones, they seen that as a memorial of what God had done. Glory to God. Yes. And you know, sometimes you go through some rough stuff and some rocky roads in your life, and every stone, you got to make sure you grab a piece of that and put it to the side so it can be a memorial so people know that you can't do something that would have destroyed someone else. But since you was with God, you walked on dry land.
Come on.
And stuff that would have drowned other folk, glory to God, it didn't drown you because you put your trust in God.
Come on now.
My God, you are his children. And he makes a way out of no way. Glory to God. He opens doors when it seems like doors begin to close on you. Glory to God. He does more than we can even ask or think. Amen. He does that.
Yes.
So in chapter 4, the Lord told Joshua to get those 12 men, each tribe, and to tell them to put a stone and make a memorial. Glory to God. So that will show what God has done for the children of Israel by crossing the Jordan on dry ground. Amen. So that was chapter 4 in 45 seconds. Now we're going to run through Joshua 5 real quick. I'm going to start at 1. Glory to God. Because we need to know a little history. Amen. Know a little history of what we're talking about. Joshua 5:1, it says this. And it came to pass. Everybody say, it came to pass.
It came to pass.
Ain't you just looking for that thing you've been praying for to come to pass?
Yes.
My God. So So then you can tell folk, and it came to pass. I'm looking for a came to pass in my life.
Come on now.
Glory to God. And it came to pass when the kings of the Amorites, which were on the side of Jordan westward, and all the kings of the Canaanites, which were by the sea, heard that the Lord had dried up the waters of Jordan before the children of Israel. My God. So the word went out to the enemies of the camp. The word went out to the enemies of the children of Israel, what the Lord has done. Glory to God. And that's what it's like today. Who will feel your anointing? Glory to God. Sometimes people are praying for your downfall, and when they hear you made it through, glory to God, they say, and it came to pass that I made it through that thing they thought I was going to drown in. Glory to God. I made it through that thing that they even prayed for my downfall. I made it through. And it came to pass. Woo! I'm excited today. And it says, until we were passed over, it says that their heart melted.
Yes.
My God, my God. It says, neither was there any spirit left in them. So basically they died. Glory to God. You ain't gotta fight your haters, because when the haters find out that you made it, their heart is gonna melt. This is what it says, what the enemies of the children of Israel went through. Check it out. It says their heart melted, and neither was there any spirit in them. Glory to God. Anymore, because of the children of Israel. Two, at that time the Lord said unto Joshua, make thee sharp knives. And circumcise again the children of Israel the second time.
Come on now.
So you talking about, it came to pass, they scared us. Now you talking about, get some knives out. Joshua, you tripping. Circumcise us again. And it says, and Joshua made him sharp knives and circumcised the children of Israel at the heel of their foreskins. And this is because, what is it? And this is the cause why Joshua did circumcise.
All right.
It says, all the people that came out of Egypt that were males, even all the men of war, died in the wilderness by the way after they came out of Egypt.
Uh-huh.
So what he's saying is, all the people that came out of Egypt, they died off. They were circumcised, because when Moses came to them, he said, hey, we got to circumcise ourselves. Amen. That was the covenant that Abraham had with God. He said, if you want to be in my covenant, I need you to circumcise yourself. So all the children of Israel, every time someone was born, on an eighth day, they circumcised them as a covenant with the Lord. Amen. So it was cutting them, and it showed blood. Amen. And it was like, you know, the blood covenant. So they were circumcised. So all of those people who were circumcised before, they died. They died in the wilderness. It was 40 years. Amen. So this is a new generation. This is a new regime. Amen.
Amen.
So that's why he said circumcise them again.
Uh-huh.
We know y'all the children of Israel, but some of y'all haven't been reared up in the circumcision.
All right.
Amen. So every male had to get cut, etc. Five. It says, now all the people that came out were circumcised, but all the people that were born in the wilderness by the way came forth out of Egypt. They had not been circumcised. Amen. So all the people who was born in the wilderness have not been circumcised.
Amen.
So they was just being born. They was knowing the customs. They knew all of this type of stuff, but they did not do the procedure of circumcision.
Amen.
Because they was on the road. They standing looking for the promised land. They was on the road. So they didn't have no time to cut no one.
Amen.
And I'm going to talk about why you need time to cut someone, but they was in a journey. Amen. Check this out. 6-9. For the children of Israel walked 40 years in the wilderness, till all the people that were men of war came out of Egypt were consumed, because they obeyed not the voice of the Lord. We know that as they left Egypt, they had some instructions to do. They didn't obey, and the 40 years was really just so they can be consumed. Amen. And it says, unto whom the Lord swore that he would show not them the land. So they was on their journey. They was out there in the wilderness. Moses was leading them. Some of them mumbled. Some of them complained. Some of them wanted water. Some of them wanted bread. Some of them wanted quail. He gave them everything they wanted. But it cost them the promised land. Amen. It says, which the Lord swear unto your fathers that will give us a land that floweth in milk and honey. Glory to God. So as they was in the process of their wilderness, they didn't expect to get the milk and the honey. They wanted something now. Have you ever been in a place where you wanted something now, but the Lord told you what he's going to give you?
Uh-huh.
My God. But you want something now.
Amen.
This is what happened with them. 7. And the children whom he raised up in the stead, then Joshua circumcised. For they were uncircumcised, because they had not circumcised them by the way. 8. And it came to pass when they had done the circumcision of all the people, they abode in their places in the camp till they were whole. Now that's the reason why they didn't stop and circumcise people. Because once you get circumcised, you gotta get healed back up. Hey, man, you gotta get healed back up. So you gotta be ready for if anything is about to come against you. Amen. So this is what's going on.
Amen.
It says that it came to pass that he had done the circumcision of all the people, and they abode in the place and the camp, and they were whole. And the Lord said unto Joshua, the day I have rolled away your approach of Egypt from off of you. Glory to God. This is the day. Excuse me. This day I have rolled away the reproach of Egypt off of you. It says, wherefore a name of this place will call Gilgal unto this day. So what he's saying, I'm circumcising all the people. Y'all gonna rest, but on this day, I cut off that reproach on you.
Yes.
I cut off that reproach on you. I brought you into covenant, but that stuff that you went through that you didn't even do, but the sins of your elders and the sins of your fourth generations before you have done, I cut that off for you. So what he's saying is, I cut off the generational curse that was on you. I cut off the stuff that your daddy's daddy did. I cut it off for you. Oh my God. Did you know that some stuff is generational?
Yes, it is.
Man, why do I act like that? Maybe because your daddy did. Why did I act like that? Maybe because your mama did. You know how they say she get it from her mama. Maybe you got to get some of that stuff off of you so you can go into the place where the Lord is calling you to.
Yes.
He says, I rolled away the reproach of Egypt from you.
Yes.
10 through 12. And it says, and the children of Israel encamped in Gilgal and kept the Passover on the 14th day of the month at the evening of the plains of Jericho.
Uh-huh.
And they did eat the old corn of the land on the morrow after the Passover, unleavened cakes and parched corn in the selfsame day. 12. And the manna ceased on the morrow after they had eaten the old corn of the land, neither had the children of Israel manna anymore, but they did eat the fruit of the land of Canaan that year. So as they was going through the wilderness, the children of Israel was getting manna every day for 40 years.
Yes.
But until this day, when he circumcised them a second time, glory to God, they just didn't get manna anymore. It says from that day they did eat from the land of Canaan. Glory to God. So if you think about that, amen, you got to get to another point in your life where you're willing to cut off everything to receive your promise.
Amen.
Glory to God. He says, after that day, that the manna ceased. The manna ceased. It was coming down every day. You can just imagine. Okay, manna, it's coming about 9 o'clock in the morning. We ready for that manna. That manna coming. It says, when they kept the Passover on this time, manna ceased on the morrow after they had eaten the old corn. My God. So God is going to get us in a place. So when the manna stopped, that was a sign that the wilderness season is over. My God. Check this out. You know when your wilderness season is over because you're not just getting barely enough. For your, like I said, it's my daily bread. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy daily bread. They received daily bread. Glory to God. But it says when the manna stopped, they was out of the wilderness. My God. We going to the land of possessing the land, right? We going to another place in our life where we want to have more than just our daily bread. Glory to God. We want to have everyday bread. Amen. We want to have a week's worth of bread. We want to have everything the Lord is going to give unto us.
Yes.
But the manna stopped. So that was a sign the wilderness season is over. And they crossed over. Glory to God. As they came to the Jordan River, the water was standing before them. They sanctified themselves. They went after the Ark of the Covenant. So they went with the presence of the Lord, right? And the presence of the Lord had to stay in the water until they all crossed.
Amen.
So when they all crossed, the presence of the Lord, they up in there waiting. And then he bowed and he said, come on up out of the water. And when, as soon as they picked up the Ark of the Covenant and got up out of that riverbank, the water overflowed again.
Yes.
The water overflowed again. Amen.
Yes.
And it says, the cutoff season. The cutoff season. Amen. And they walked into another one. Glory to God. God wants to be in covenant with you. He says, circumcise them again. Oh my God. Circumcise them again. Now I'm going to touch on Romans 2:29 real quick. So I can just, you know, have these in comparisons. We're talking about the natural, but we want to also talk about the spiritual. Because nowadays you don't have to be circumcised with a knife.
Come on.
in the church.
Come on.
Y'all will see Pastor Rube up here sharpening my knives. I'm not up here sharpening knives. So you can be calm. No circumcision today. Romans 2 and 29, it says this: but he is a Jew which is one inwardly, and the circumcision is that of the heart and the spirit. Glory to God. Not in the letter, whose praise is not of man but of God. So what he's talking about, what we have to do, we have to circumcise our hearts. Glory to God. We have to circumcise our hearts. Like we said, we want to be set apart. We want to sanctify ourselves. But we got to sanctify our heart. But we have to cut those things that's not like God in our heart. Because in our heart, we know in our heart is evil things. Glory to God. We know in our heart is things that we really don't want to tell everybody about. Sometimes you just got to cut those things off. Glory to God. Because when we all, before you even get in God, let's say you in your wilderness, right?
Yes.
Before you give God your heart, you in your wilderness. You really don't know really what's going on. Once you get God in your life, now you kind of have a feel of what's going on. But it's some stuff that you got to cut off.
Yes, come on.
It's some stuff that you got to cut off in your heart, amen, to even love better. Sometimes when I always think about it, I say, man, I was an evil dude. Amen. And I had to cut that evil dude off to be a good dude.
Come on.
Amen. I had to cut that evil stuff off of me so I could be a good dude, so I could walk with the good news.
Yes. Come on.
Amen. I needed to be a good dude so I could walk with the good news.
Yes.
Amen. I didn't want to be an evil guy no more. I didn't want to do things that was devilish.
Come on.
Sinful.
Yes.
Amen. Because I wanted to get in this covenant for real with God. Because I knew if I gave up all those things and I cut some stuff off my heart, he could give me all things. And I'm thinking that if I give up this, he wouldn't give it back, but he did. My God, when you feel like you can't cut those things off around your heart, that means you need to. Amen. This, when you thinking you can't do it, that's when you need to do it. Glory to God. Everybody's like, man, I can't do it. I can't go to church, man. I'm messed up. That's when you need to go.
Yes.
Glory to God. Hey, I ain't ready yet. That's when you need to go. Yes. Amen. So when you go, you can find out, man, I was really tore up from the floor up.
Yes.
Amen. I was really tore up from the floor up. I said, Lord, I want you to clean my heart up. I want you to cut those things out. Amen. I want to have a heart of flesh. Because sometimes your heart may be hard.
Come on.
My God, sometimes it might not even take a knife. You're going to have to get a hammer and a chisel. Bow. And sometimes the hammer is a chisel. It gives you the opportunity, but sometimes life is going to chisel at your heart.
That's right.
Boosh.
That's right.
Boosh. Boosh. And you be like, Lord Jesus, that hurts. I know. Boosh. Boosh. Like, oh Lord, I can't take another one. Yes, you can. Boosh.
Come on.
Oh Lord, why is this hurting? Because I'm trying to get to your heart. Boosh. Good Lord, I can't take it no more. Boosh. And it just exploded and it's just shattering. And now you're you won't hurt you no more, because yeah, todo boso casi casa, because now you got a new heart.
Come on now.
He wants to exchange that hard heart for a heart of flesh. Circumcision of the heart. He says, circumcise them again. Woo. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Because sometimes when you go through a wilderness, your heart does get hard. You feel like you can't trust no one. You feel like, you know, you can't depend on nobody. You feel like you can't do nothing, but your hard heart begins to mold. It's hard. You go through things over. Woo, thank you, Lord. You go through things over and over and over and over again. Just like if you think about how they dip chocolate and they make chocolate. It's a covering. It's a layer. Glory to God. It's a layer. It's a layer. You go through so much stuff in your life, it just seems like it's a layer in your life. It goes over and over and over again. But he said, it's time for circumcision. Glory to God. It's time for me to get up in that place. And the only time I can get into that place is with that hammer and that chisel.
Yes. Thank you.
Boom.
Stony heart.
Stony heart. It's cutoff season. It's time to cut off that stuff, those rough edges. My God, because he said, I want to get you someplace.
Yes.
Glory to God. I want to give you the opportunity to know who I am. I want you to sit up a memorial. Check this out. all of those rocks that fell to the ground off your heart, pick them up and lay them to the side as a memorial. Glory to God for what I have brought you from. My God, what I have brought you from. I have brought you from that little place and to mold you into this place. Cut off season. He wants you to cut those things off around your heart. Glory to God. Cut those things off around your heart. So now we can get a covenant with God. A covenant with God. A covenant with God. So now the children of Israel, they came out of this place. They about to go to Jericho. They about to go fight. It was 40,000 men of war. Amen. And they knew how to fight. They knew how to do all this thing. But it was one thing that they was lacking. The circumcision. Glory to God. They was ready to take the land. They was ready to do what they needed to do. But one thing they needed to do was to get cut. You about to tell me I'm about to go to war, but you want me to get cut before I go? My God, my God. And this is what happened. They had to pitch a tent because after that cut, they was ready. My God. After you get cut, then you'll be ready.
That's right.
My God, some people are like, man, I'm ready. No, you ain't. It's time to get cut.
Right.
Especially if you want to go further with the Lord. Amen. He said, I want you guys to sanctify yourselves. They sanctify themselves. Now he told them, now it's time to circumcise yourselves.
Amen.
So you can just imagine, they're like, Joshua, man. Come on, man. So they went and pitched the camp and Gilgal. They sat there. They got back strong. They got back ready. Now they're ready to fight.
Right.
Now they're ready to fight for the Lord. Now they see that the Lord is with Joshua like he was with Moses.
Yes.
We're going to listen to everything he said.
Yes.
We're going to listen to everything he said because we know what happened. We know he dried up those waters. We know what he done. We know that he cut those things off. Glory to God. He know he cut them things off. Now check this out. This is everything that the Lord does. He does it in, illustrations. He cut the water off of the Jordan. Glory to God. And he cut something off of Israel.
That's right. Come on.
My God, he cut the water off in Jordan, and he cut some off of Israel. Now, everybody knew what was going on in the children of Israel. Now, you know you got a good God. If he's going to feed you for 40 years, daily bread, it's going to be a cloud in the day and fire by night. He's going to lead you, so he got your front and your back. Even though he got you running around this mountain all those times, he's feeding you. He's protecting you.
Yes.
He's clothing you.
Yes.
He's doing all of these things. And this is what we talk about, the permissive will. The permissive will was, we need to do it this way. But the perfect will of God was, we would have got there in 11 days. The children of Israel would have got there in 11 days, but they wanted to follow their own mind and follow what they wanted to do. Amen? So now he says it's time for you ought to be circumcised again. All those other people who didn't really obey me, they have been consumed. Now it's time for you to take the land for real, for real.
Amen.
And I want you to be circumcised.
Yes.
And do this to show that your covenant is with me.
Yes.
That's right.
All the ones that were born in the wilderness. All those ones who was coming up and reared up and know all the things of the Lord. They waking up, they getting ready for battle. They can see the promised land.
Yes, sir.
Because it's over Jordan, amen. You know, you can see it. My God. It's so close you can taste it.
Right.
You've been praying for your breakthrough. It's so close you can taste it.
Come on,
you've been having dreams of it. You waking up out your dream like, man, I got a new car. You know, you waking up, oh, I'm in a new house.
Yes.
You're so close to it. You can just imagine yourself in it.
Yes.
But he said, before you get to that place, sanctify yourself and circumcise yourself.
Yes, Lord.
And there's a reason why the Lord wanted to get a covenant with them.
Yeah.
The Lord knows all things, right?
Yeah.
He want to get you tied up. What is it? Wrapped up and tied up in him before you get the blessing.
Yeah.
Check it out.
Yeah.
He want to get you wrapped up, tied up in him before you get the blessing. Because when you get the blessing, it's going to mess up your thinking.
That's right. Come on.
Yeah.
They've been in the wilderness so long. They wasn't expecting the blessing of the promised land. So he said, I want you guys to get in covenant with me. So before you get this blessing, it's going to overtake you. It's going to be a blessing for you. But we find out right after this here, fast forward and paraphrase.
That's right, come on.
It messed up. Again. The same ones that who got circumcised again, they messed up again. Because when they got into the place of the promised land, the Lord told them, don't do certain things. And they fell again.
Yeah.
and they fell again. Amen. So what this was, all the Bible is history lessons. Glory to God. It's confirmations. Glory to God. Of what not to do. Hallelujah. And what you should try to do.
Amen.
You should try to be a better person every day. Right? Every day. I try my best to be nothing like how I was. Amen. Every day I thank the Lord. Praise God. I love somebody today. Praise God. I thank you, Lord, that I don't have a gun no more. Can I be honest? Thank you, Lord, that, you know, the dude looking at me crazy in the car, if he stopped, I'm going to put these hands on him. Can I just be honest, right? Y'all act like y'all have road rage.
That's right. Come on.
But if somebody pull it, you got to pull it, right?
That's right.
Am I talking to a real folk today? Case in point, I was on my way home the other day, and these guys, they crunk. I'm just riding. They look at me, I look at them. He look at me again, I'm like, he better not go to this light. I'm just being honest, but he kept on rolling. I'm just being real. I would have told him, man, I'll pass him, man. But then if he would have tripped.
Lord Jesus. Oh,
Lord Jesus. You try to, you know, stop confrontation. Amen. So, you just got to be in that place of knowing that some things are happening in your life for a reason.
Walking tall.
Amen. Because sometimes I'm like, I thank God I ain't got a gun. I would have just flashed a gun. Like,
Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost. The truth shall set you free.
Walking tall.
Who's the lie to you? Because people see a peace, they ain't going to think peace, right?
Walk and talk. That's right.
Just being real. Yes. If they see a peace, they ain't no looking crazy no more.
That's right. Come on.
And that's what's going on right now. People want to put fear in you.
That's right.
I ain't scared of nothing.
Lord,
he ain't
Lord,
gave us
Jesus,
the spirit of fear. Amen.
Right.
I'm just keeping it real though, you know. He ain't raised no punks. Yeah, no weapon formed against you is impossible. But we live in a crazy world.
That's right.
People just, you know, thinking it's okay, you know.
Jesus,
you gotta watch your surroundings.
Yeah.
I bet you ain't gonna let nobody come mess with y'all.
Come on.
Amen.
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 Come on.
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, we praying for peace.
Yeah. One man, one.
So I just wanted to use that as an example. Thank God I ain't how I used to be. So I could just keep on going in my life and just thank God for the new me. Glory to God. And they should. Listen, your people who cry to come up against you should be thankful that you ain't who you used to be. They better be thankful you ain't who you used to be. My God. I be telling people now, I say, ooh, I don't know how I be doing in this new day and time. My God. Be off the chain. But thank God for my heart changing.
Lord Jesus.
Thank God for my heart changing. Amen.
Amen.
So at now as my heart changing, I could be in a new generation and talk to the new generation. Hey, you need to be circumcised. Glory to God. You may be out in the wilderness, but the Lord want to bring you into his marvelous light. So as he brings you into your marvelous light, you can drop those pieces. Amen. You can drop those hateful thoughts. You can drop those things of negativity and try to do things differently.
Yes, Lord.
It's a process, though. Everybody say it's a process. My God, you got to walk to where you're trying to go. By faith.
Walk and talk.
By faith. So the children of Israel, they had to be circumcised for the second time. Because he was trying to get them to a place. He already knew, I'm going to circumcise you all. As you guys get circumcised, the man is about to stop.
Amen.
The manna is about to stop. And then it says, neither they ate manna anymore.
Uh-huh.
So that was a sign right there. We hear it. Glory to God. Yes. We here now. Manna has stopped. My God, we about to go into the promised land.
Amen.
My God, the Lord is about to do some things in us because he did some stuff inside of us.
Uh-huh.
Some of us like, Lord, when you going to do it? He's trying to get something to you,
Lord,
the whole
Jesus,
time.
Come on.
He's trying to get something to you the whole time. Glory to God. But we like this, and he got the knife.
Come on.
We expecting the blessing, but he said the blessing is in your heart.
Yeah.
The blessing is, you got to receive it first before it can come naturally. Amen. Yeah. Receive it by faith before it can come naturally. He just want to cut some stuff around us. Like I always tell folks, you know, I got the same outside, but my heart is new.
That's right. Come on.
My God, I got the same outside, but my heart is new. The Lord looks at the heart. Amen. The man looks at the appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart. It all talks about the heart. It's all about the circumcision of the heart. He wants to circumcise us around our heart again. It's cut off season. It's cut. You know how you cut stuff into a heart. He just want to, like art class. I hate getting cut.
Come on.
Hate nails. Hate the dentist. I hate all those things. I hate them all. But they got to correct some things, right?
That's right.
They got to correct some things. Glory to God. Preventive measures can help out a long preventive maintenance can help out temporary mistakes for long-term situations. You can write it down, but that's what I was trying to get to, because that was fresh. The Lord want to prevent some stuff that could be temporary, but if you don't prevent it now, it can be long-term, if that makes sense. As I'm listening to him, I can just hear what he's saying. He's trying to cut off some stuff that could just be something temporary. Uh-huh. But if you don't cut it, it can become permanent. Uh-huh. You know, sometimes you got to get hurt enough so you can let it go.
Lord Jesus, come on.
Have you ever been hurt so much in your life?
Yes.
You say, won't nobody else hurt me like that again?
Uh-huh.
Let's be real. Uh-huh. So you know what you do with that? You cut that off.
Yeah, come on.
Can't nobody hurt me like that no more. That job ain't gonna hurt me like that no more. Them church folks sure ain't gonna hurt me like that no more.
Amen. Come on.
I'm just being real, right? That girl ain't gonna hurt me like that no more. That man sure ain't gonna hurt me like that. Chainsaw. Then the brick to the windshield. Then the flat tires. Y'all know y'all ladies, y'all gonna win, right? Oh, he ain't gonna do nothing like that no more. Baby, you know I love you. We gotta cut that off, right? But you making sure that you never get hurt like that again. So then, check this out. Now you putting up walls. Now you're putting up walls again. Now he's saying, now it's time to circumcise that again.
Yeah.
Because he said, now you're trying to protect your own heart, and I'm the one who's supposed to protect you.
Come on.
My God. My God. My God. You know how it feels like a void in your heart after you get hurt?
Yes.
He says, I'm the one who's supposed to fill that up.
Yes.
Don't try to fill something up with something that's not me.
Amen.
Because if you do, it'll be brittle. It'll be easily hurt again, right?
That's right.
So then that's when it says, confess with your mouth and believe in your
heart.
Wow, we're talking about heart again, right?
Yes.
So now if something is messing up my heart, now I can't trust like I used to. If something is messing with my heart, now I can't believe like I used to. So now we got to confess out of our mouth and believe in our
heart.
That all things are possible to whom though believe in what the Lord has said according to my life. As I cut those things off around my heart so my heart can be perfect so I can listen to what the Lord is saying to me. Man, it's powerful, y'all. And all we got to do is just get into that place of, okay, let me evaluate my life. Okay, it's 2016, about to go to 2017. I've been hurt a few times. Let me cut that off. Lord, fill me up.
Amen.
Lord, fill me up with you, okay? Okay, Lord, you filling me up? Oh, man, I'm back on the grind. Oh, I'm back doing my thing. I'm back working. Oh, something else pop up. But now I'm looking because now I don't trust everybody.
Come on.
But then the Lord says, didn't you cut that off?
That's right. Come on.
Didn't you cut that off? Didn't I give you manna every day in the wilderness? So now this makes you think of even about your provision. Don't worry about your provision because guess what? You ate since last week. You drank some water since last week, right? So the Lord, he's going to steadily provide. It might not be what you want, but you can appreciate what he gives. Amen. It's about circumcising your heart. Amen. So when you circumcise your heart, now you can believe whatever the Lord tell you, and you're going to stand on the word he tell you. And every time you beat your heart and you crack that stony ground, put that stuff up and just tell people what you've been through. So they can see what the Lord has done for you. They can probably do for them as they're going through something and they don't know what to do. Just say, have you ever circumcised your heart lately? Have you cut off some stuff in your heart lately? My God. Sometimes you have a weary heart. My God. You just got a weary heart. Just like, man, you know, this is weighing me down. You know, I don't know what to do. Cut some of that stuff off. Cut some of that stuff off. Make it a heart of flesh. And that's what he's saying in Romans 2:29. But he is a Jew which one is inwardly. Circumcision, that of the heart, in the spirit.
Yes.
Not in the letter, whose praise is not of men, but of God.
Yes.
But of God. When you start changing your verbiage to say, God gets the glory, or my God, or if it had not been for God on my side. Those are the testimonies that people need to hear. Not like, oh yeah, I did this. No, God gets the glory.
That's right.
God brought me out of that. God brought me from a mighty long way. He brought me out of Egypt. I was locked up, I was chained up, but he brought me a mighty long way. Even when it seemed impossible, he parted those waters. Not once, but twice. So he don't want me to get circumcised but once, but twice, but a lot of times.
That's right.
Sometimes I gotta stop myself from snapping on her. Just keep it real. What you mean, woman? That's why I have to change it. What do you mean?
That's right.
My love. Honey. You know, you gotta change some things.
Make a change. Come on.
You know, but she fight back now. Y'all gonna see Pastor up here preaching the sunglasses. I wasn't buying that fighting devil. But I always say she got a little fist, so I'd be a little black eye right here. But you just gotta circumcise some things.
That's right.
Amen. So that's what the Lord wants us to know, what the children of Israel went through, so we can apply that to our life as we head into the promised land. Amen. As we head into possessing the land. He wants us to be completely.
That's
Amen.
Right.
He wants us to be completely great. Just trusting him, believing in him, and getting those things out of our heart. Amen. When you get those things out of your heart, now you can love like you're supposed to. Amen. It just be good love. You know what I mean? Not no freaky love or none of that. It's just good love. The love of God shed abroad in my
heart. Jesus, come on.
See, it always goes back to the for the issues of life, and the mouth speaks. Out of the heart, out of the abundance of the
heart,
it goes to your heart.
Come on.
So if our heart is messed up, we come on now.
Amen.
We got to check our heart, because if our heart is messed up, you don't want to come to church.
Amen.
You don't want to give.
Amen.
You don't want to do nothing for the church.
That's right.
But also, you don't want to help your community.
Uh-huh.
You don't want to do nothing for your neighbors. Neighbors always ask for eggs. Uh-huh. Eggs and sugar. Your mama ain't got no. You know,
Lord Jesus, come on.
I'll just give it milk, cigarettes, bread, whatever. What else you may ask for? Cornbread, Miracle Whip. I'm like, we got money to come over for dinner. Kool-Aid. Hey, y'all got some sugar? Yeah, we got sugar. Y'all got some red Kool-Aid? Y'all got some ice trays. I'm just looking for real. When you live in a project, you know what it is. It's no joke, amen. When you talk about spiritual things is kind of hard to talk about, as you want to talk about some stuff that's going to change people's lives. Amen. So I just thank God for the word on today. Amen. So that's why some of them reflections I had to think of as he's giving them to me. Amen. Because he's want to change some stuff in our life. I'm like, well, God, how can I turn this into a sermon talking about cutting some stuff in your heart?
Bless God.
I thank God that he worded my mouth on today. And I'm encouraged. Amen. I'm encouraged. Because he want to give us the history of what the children of Israel had went through. So how we can apply it to our life. Amen.
Yes.
How you can apply it to our life. Because he has some things in store for us.
Amen.
But he want to be in covenant with us.
Bless God.
He want to be in covenant. He's not a covenant breaker. He doesn't breach the contract. Amen.
Yes.
And he want us to make sure we hold up our end of the bargain with him. Amen.
Yes.
My job is to get you guys closer to him. My job is to get you guys and keep you guys in line to learn that you got to trust God. Amen. That's what my job is. Amen. Amen. As a shepherd of this house, I just want to, amen, bless you. I just want to, man, lead you guys into green grass. Amen. I was on my way home, and I was driving, and it's a little lawn place on the side of the road on Lindbergh, and it says, fresh new green grass. I said, yes, Lord. I said, yes, Lord. Amen. Yes, Lord. And if you have no idea, Pastor had lost his all his other sermons. I really never went back for them anyway, but I had to lose them, I guess. You know what I mean? Yeah. To get ready for this new season that's, that's putting us into. And I'm excited about that. Amen. Yeah. So we can continue to go and go higher. Amen. Yeah. Go higher in the Lord. Amen. The Lord, you can continue to go to the stars and to the heavens in Him. Amen.
We can do this too.
There's countless things that you can do for the Lord to bring Him glory. Yes. And I'm excited that we can bring Him glory collectively. Amen. Amen. Truly, truly blessed. Yes, circumcision in our hearts so we can be some good children of God. Amen. In our personal lives. Amen. I know I see you guys here, but I don't know what you guys go through outside. Right? You know what I mean? I want you to know how to apply this stuff here out there. Because I'm trying my best. Y'all pray for your family. Somebody look crazy. I'm just being real. I try to be a real dude, you know? But I ain't about to let nobody disrespect me. Amen.
Amen.
That's why you gotta pray. Pray for y'all too. You know, you ain't gonna let nobody do you any type of work.
That's right.
Thank you, Lord. Say it in my heart.
Yes, Lord.
I'm gonna testify after this. Amen. Heavenly Father, we give you praise. We give you honor. We give you glory. We thank you for being real today, God. We thank you for the seeds, Lord God, that have been sown today. Thank you for those who had a heart to give, Lord God. We give you praise. We give you honor. We give you glory. We believe in our 100-fold blessing, Lord God. We thank you for financial increase, Lord God. We thank you for jobs. We thank you for promotion, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for open the windows of heaven in the name of Jesus. We thank you for storehouse blessings. We thank you for influx in the name of Jesus. We give you praise, honor, and the glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I want to be a real man of God. Amen. And stuff try to test you, you know. I'm riding. I see the dude in the backseat. He crunk. He got his hands out the window. You know, what are you on? Then I look at him. They look and they pass me. He get his hands up the window. This time now it's a middle finger, right? So I'm like, Lord. Didn't that happen? But I'm just like, Lord, bless them young kids. They don't know what's going on out here.
Right, right, right.
You know what I'm saying? Bless them young kids out here, Lord. Man, I was like, you know, people have no idea. You know, I could have had a bad day that day. I could have chased them down. Thank you for the Holy Ghost. I'm glad that light didn't change your
life.
You know how sometimes, I'm testifying first, right? Sometimes back in the day, I would issue the fight. I just pull up, just thinking this, if I use my young.
Now come back.
We pull up, we at the light. What's up? Yeah, y'all turn up.
Jesus. All right. Polite. Come on.
I'm saying I wasn't polite, though. But I'm just saying, you know. I'm like, y'all turn, huh? You see the face? You know, I'm just like, my God, people want to take me back real quick. You know how quick it is to go back?
Come back. Come on.
But you know how quick it is to come back, though.
Yeah.
Snap like that. You don't even know what's going on.
That's right.
My God, y'all pray with me. That's one thing. I still don't play no games. You hear me? I smile. Lord knows I do. My God, I've been too much to play.
You got walk and talk.
Especially with some kids. You know, I know I still look young. Got a little grays. Don't pull it, young man. I'm telling you. This is not what you want. You just gotta be honest. I'm just saying. So my testimony is I thank God for deliverance. I was aggressive. I would go through the opposition hood and just riding. This is a testimony again. One time I'm riding through and my gas hand don't work. Check this out. I'm riding through the opposition hood. I'm, yeah, gang bang. I turn the corner, my car run out of gas.
One band, one sound.
One band, one sound. And it wasn't no sound because I got out that car. Quietly, shut the door. It's in my sin, you know what I'm saying? I ain't had no reason riding through their neighborhood. And I ran out of gas. I can tell you God's grace and mercy. I'm just saying. Little stuff like that. Just
think that's real. Come on.
That's real, Ray. Thank God for deliverance.
Yes,
my God. It didn't care about dying. You feel me? Didn't care about going to try to murder somebody, you know? Change my
dangerous
heart, man. I just thank God that what I'm just saying, though, you know, don't try that. I just got to be real, y'all. It's too much stuff going out here. And people
it's dangerous.
Crazy, you know what I'm saying? And you just got to be watched for your surroundings, you know what I'm saying? People want to take you to that level, man. And they know that's the reason. You know when stuff heightens up, it's because a blessing is on the way.
Amen.
Amen. Stuff trying to make you be who you used to be right before you get to your breakthrough.
That's right.
That's right.
So don't fall for it. Amen.
To mothers, everybody in the house, I thank God for his blessing. I thank God for the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Wait, one more day.
Right here.
Yes.
Back in the days, I didn't know about it. Baby, yeah, I didn't know his heart was like that.
Right.
Because I would come home to Mama and eat up all the food. Hey, Mama, I love him, kiss him, and then you
can
leave
him alone.
He was a goody-goody baby, you know. But just like my elder, my bald head preacher, I didn't know he was back there in the hay. He wasn't in no games, I don't think, but he was. Yeah. Aren't you covered?
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
You're covered under the blood of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
And I thank God for that. Yeah, God, just pray for me that I be still humble at Jesus' feet.
Yeah.
Bless
you, Lord. Yeah.
Givelify is giving simplified. Givelify is the fastest and easiest way to donate to the church, charity, or cause of your choice. You're not limited to the cash you have on hand. There's no need to write checks, and there are no complicated sign-up forms to fill out, websites, or text message codes to remember. Givelify automatically pinpoints your location and intelligently identifies the fundraiser or church service you're attending without the need to search. Since Givelify automatically detects where you are, making a donation can be completed in as few as 3 taps. Tap 1, use one of the pre-configured denominations to specify the donation amount. Tap 2, select the specific campaign to which you'd like to contribute. Tap 3, with your stored credit card, complete your donation in 1 tap. You get an immediate donation receipt, and you can even share your generosity on Facebook or Twitter. Givelify lets you easily see your donation history with any church or charity you donate to. You can also accurately track your donations for your taxes without needing to hunt down receipts, bank statements, or acknowledgement letters. You can also set your home and favorites. Mark churches as your favorites so you can donate as frequently and generously as you'd like, even when you're thousands of miles away. Mark the church you normally attend as your home church for quick one-tap access. Givelify. Tap. Give. Done.